Welcome to Gen TV Channel 7. Today we will witness an ancient friendship happened in the pre-colonial Philippines and ancient China. The story of the East Sulu King, Sultan Paduka Pahala and Emperor Yongle of Ming Dynasty China. I'm Gen TV Channel 7, and if you like our channel, please like, share and subscribe and hit the notification bell for updates. Thank you. A Sulu king named Paduka Pahala was probably the first diplomat who sailed from the Philippines to Imperial China in 1417. Using an ancient boat called Balangay, Pahala sailed across seas with stopovers in Brunei, Cambodia, Vietnam and Guangzhou. It was believed that he was with 324 members of his delegation, with two of his wives, three children, and high-ranking officials. When Sultan Pahala arrived in China, their delegation made a strong impression on the Chinese emperor and made him the most important guest during that time, with welcome party and military honor.
Pahala's visit was recorded in the 325th chapter of Ming Annals. It reads, in 1417, Sultan Paduka Batara Pahala, with a retinue of 340 wives, ministers and retainers, sailed across the South Seas to the Chinese capital of Beijing and presented to Emperor Yongle a memorial inscribed in gold, such tributes as pearls, precious stones, and tortoise shells.
They registered with the Minister of Rites on September 12, 1417, as Sultan Paduka Batara Pahala of the East Country, Maharaja Kolaminting of the West Country, and Paduka Prabhu, with their delegation of 340 people. Yongle, one of China's most famous emperors, made a grandiose welcome to the Sulu King in the 72-hectare Forbidden City. Thousands of his guards, royal court, and concubines welcomed him, where they also presented gifts. The Sultan and the Chinese Emperor gain a trust with each other and cherish a moment to talk about between their two countries in a short span of time.
Vojska byla zahnána na útěk. Nyní vaše veličenstvo vládne světu neomezenou mocí. A proto volám, ať žije císař.
Čengu. Za své vítězství vděčím svému otci, tobě i obětem vojáků. Ostatně jsem tím plnil jenom tře.
After 27 days in China, Pahala and his delegation planned to sail back to Sulu, but he contracted an unknown disease and eventually died. His family and officers stayed in China and never went home. Upon learning of the death of his new friend, Yongle, Zhu Di immediately commissioned artisans and sculptors to build a tomb for the deceased monarch, which still stands today. It was not an ordinary tomb. The emperor bestowed an imperial burial and tombstone. Pahala also got a portrait where he's sitting in a dragon throne wearing the emperor's clothes with two of his wives in the background. Emperor Yongle presented Beijing in Dezhou, Shandong Province, a village where Pahala's family can live. Eventually, intermarriages with the Wei people happened and Pahala now has over 6,000 direct descendants living in China. When the Ming Dynasty collapsed, all privileges given to Pahala's family were scrapped off. Thus, some of his relatives and descendants moved away from his village. Pahala's living descendants carry the Chinese family names, An and Wen. In 1987, the Filipino-Chinese epic historical drama Hari Sa Hari, Lahi Sa Lahi premiered. It was directed by national artist for cinema Eddie Romero, Xiao Lang and Cho Lily, starring Vic Vargas and Wong Sing Gang, about Paduka Pahala's visit to the Chinese Empire. This story between Paduka Pahala and Yongle isn't known to us Filipinos. This might spark criticism at a time where we have a spat between our two countries. But let us remember history as we set forward. We should understand history as it is integral in a good understanding. This allows people to create and to change upon a secure foundation. None of these can be undertaken properly without understanding the context and starting points.